Today, friends, I'm going to show you how to use the Tinkercad Sketch Tool to add colors to an SVG file. So let's get cracking. To make things faster, we are going to start with a bit.ly. Once again, you can find this in the description or simply type bit.ly/sketchduck and press enter. This is a project that was posted in my Patreon. The user wants to know how to add color and turn it into a tray. Once again, it is set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy and tinker. All right, so real quickly, this image up here in the corner was supplied to me by one of my Patreon users. I used Pick SVG to turn it into an SVG. Brought it in, and then the user wants to create a bin. So the first thing I'm going to do is hit Control D, and I'm going to change this one to Silhouette. This will be the bottom of the bin. I'm going to make it 1 millimeter thick. For this part, I'm also going to make it white, just so it's easier to see. Out here we had the default fill. I'm going to leave it just like it is. I'm going to leave it as it is. But I'm going to do Control D, and this is going to be the outside walls of the project by turning on the outer line. I choose round. I'm going to make the walls 1.2 millimeters thick, and I'm going to bump up the quality. It takes a moment for it to settle, and then you can raise that to whatever height you wanted your bin to be. All right, so this is how we're going to paint this. Do W for work plane and click up on this white area. I want to let you know the white was set at 1. This black is set at 1.5. So check out this combination. If we set the sketch out here, we're going to simply draw these pieces that we need to be orange, and we're going to set them a little bit lower. If you've never used Sketch before, these are the sketch features. This gets updated all the time with new tricks that they're adding. There are cool animations, 5 different screens full of awesome information. You can check this out at your leisure. Once you're done, you can simply hit continue to sketch to return to build. If you ever want to check it again, it's right there. If you prefer my tutorials, of course, you can use this bit.ly right here or the link in the cards. Now we're going to just fill in this orange super quick using Sketch. Press number 2 to make a Bezier curve. We're going to start right here. We're going to click, hold, and twist until it goes in the darker line. I'm going to intentionally leave that one out. We could also, and I'll show you right now, press number 1 to start it going the direction we want, then hit number 2 again to click, hold, and twist and get it so it's in that line. We simply want to follow the duck's bill all the way around, and we're going to make that orange. I'm going to do the number 1 trick to unbend it, 2 to get it back to Bezier curve, click, hold, and twist. I'm going to do number 1 to come up this way. Right here, I want to bend around, so I'm going to click, hold, and twist. I'm going to leave this a little wonky. We'll fix it in a minute. And then I'm going to click and hold the bend here, click and hold the bend there, and it's just click, hold, and twist to get all the way around this duck's beak. This is a nice one because I can cover a lot of territory at once. I'll fix that in a minute, and we can click, hold, and twist to finish it. You can kind of see how that looks like the duck's beak. Once we double click, we can see the points we made and fix it. These are what's called smooth corners. If we press number 3, they become broken corners, and now I can shrink one without adjusting the other. You can also grab the points and move them, and we just want to do that all the way around the shape until it goes everywhere we want. This piece right here is a smooth handle. See how they both adjust? I'm going to hit number 3 to make it broken, and now I can bring that one back inside the darker line. Easy peasy. This comes around like it's supposed to. I did want to avoid this little spot right here. We're going to hit number 3 to make that broken, and that's okay, but you know what? I'm going to hit number 4 to add a point. I do want to let you know, though, after you add a point, you got to hit V. Notice if you just click the point, it goes away. I'm going to do Control Z to bring that back, and now I am going to hit V, and that allows me to tweak and adjust these so they don't run into this spot right here. Check it out. When we hit Finish Sketch, we have now got the beak, which looks goofy at size 10, but if we change that size to 0.4, And of course, make it orange. It looks fantastic. How cool is that? Let's quickly paint the eyes. Click on this one, do Control D. Double click to edit it. And don't be shocked, we're gonna delete everything that's in there. The other one is below it, and now we're gonna draw a brand new one to do the eyes. P for pen, 2 for Bezier curve. Let's start right here. I'm gonna click, hold, and twist to get in that darker line. It misses a little bit, but I'll fix it in a moment. I wanna come right along this line. So I'm gonna hit number 1 so that we start this direction, and then number 2 so I can do the click, hold, and twist to follow that. This twist a different way than I want, but I'm gonna still do the modify. I'm gonna click, hold, and twist. Click, hold, and twist. And just click to finish. It's super quick to click inside and edit. I'm gonna click on this point right here and switch it from smooth to broken. And that easily allows me to adjust those so they're in the line I want. I do wanna show you this. You can hit the number 1 and make it a straight line. So you can easily modify these. This one right here looks like it needs a 3. Bang, click, and check that out. Now I wanna do the same thing over here. I'm gonna double click to edit that. Let's hit P for pen. I'm gonna do number 2, and I'm gonna do this one backwards. We're just gonna go around the other way. Once again, click, hold, and twist. Get it so it's close. Click, hold, and twist. And click, hold, and twist. 4 points, double click. Of course, that needs to be number 3, which is broken. Let's pull it inside. Make sure that it's always in the dark gray. And let's hit finish sketch. Of course, those need to be some sort of awesome light blue. Let's go custom in the blues, find the one we think is super cool, and bang, painted. Now we do have an error. Check this out though. If we double click, we can simply grab that point, move it where it's supposed to be, adjust the handles. Let's double check again. How cool is that? Same trick to do the pink, but I'm gonna try and do it all in one part. We're gonna do Control D. I'm gonna double click. We're gonna delete everything that's in there. Once again, we're just repeating those steps using the 1 and the 2 and then adjusting afterwards. Let's speed it up with some video editing. And let's hit finish and check it out. One step, let's make it a pink. Pick whichever color you like. I'm gonna put work plane on the ground and we have just colored all those parts. There are a few black parts we need to fill in as well, these little holes in the eyes. We're gonna do that with this blue one. Once again, Control D, double click to edit. Grab both pieces in here and delete them. Zoom in on this one, and we're just gonna make a tiny diamond. Doesn't have to be perfectly shaped. You're just making a diamond shape. Then when you double click it to edit it, double click it again, and it auto smooths. How cool is that? If we hit finish sketch, we need to make that one black. And then also we need to change its height to match the black areas, which is 0.5, and press enter. Now when those merge, that one will be perfect. I'm gonna go inside that one again by hitting double click. And this time, we're gonna copy and paste it to useful areas. So if I zoom out, I can hit Control C and Control V, and I'm gonna just grab that and set it where it needs to go. I'm gonna do Control V again. I need one up here. Control V again. I need one over here. You don't need one here. That's the white eyeball. You do need one in this area. We'll edit it in a minute. We also need one right here. Control V. And then I also see one down here and down here. So Control V. And Control V. So inside each of these, we simply double click, grab the little points, and move them where they need to be. Just like that, hole filled. This one right here, hole filled. This one over here, maybe zoom in a little bit. You can, of course, adjust the handles, but that filled that one as well. I think the full trace is actually going to be faster for these, so I'm going to hit delete, and I'm going to hit P for pen, and we'll trace it just like I did before and speed it up with video editing. Boom. Drop them in place. Let's hit finish sketch, click somewhere else, check out the awesome duck. Now, if you want to make those all blend in, let's click on the white one and do Control H to hide it. Same for the orange, we can hide it. Also the blue and the pink. So I'm gonna do Control H after shift clicking those. I'm also gonna hide the walls. Now we can grab all of these parts and do Control G to union group them. Notice they turn red for a little bit, but then when we do show all, bingo, it looks like one solid project. All right, so a quick review. Of course, I want to say thanks to Benny for the original question. I hope you all had a ton of fun with this template, and I hope that you're getting a lot better at using the sketch tool. Of course, I've got a full playlist of tutorials, some super useful, some fun like this. You can find it, of course, with the bit.ly up above or by checking the cards. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that has chosen one of my YouTube memberships. Don't forget, there are three different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you, of course, get early access to videos. I do quickly want to say thank you to everybody that's part of my Patreon. Love how that group is growing. It has a free messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, get support. That is where Benny obviously asked this question, and it was a ton of fun. So a huge shout out to her. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.